I love going to the forest. Wow, that's a lot. Let me today, ladies and gentlemen, take you to the deep sanctuary. Not exactly to the deep sanctuary, but the village near it called Laduri. Now, the village Laduri had a small population of around 25 people. And having a very small population, they were very closely knit. They were very closely knit like a family. Everyone knowing each other, everyone living so peacefully, everyone helping each other in everything possible. And the beauty about the village was that it was just besides the being so very opulent, so very gifted by nature. It will feel like as if we are going to a resort when you go to the village. Everything was all set, everything was so beautiful in the village. But unfortunately, it seemed suddenly that a bad woman a bad spell has been pulled upon them. So, in the past few months, there were tiger sightings in the village. And two of the villagers were almost killed. Somehow they saved them. This had left the villagers very scared. This had left the villagers fighting among themselves. Yet they decided that whenever a lion will be sighted, they will take all their weapons and fight to save the village. After all, they were close to the village. So it happened that along with the bad event that were happening, there were three pranksters in the village by the name Brij Gopal, Bake Bihari and Govardhan. Now Brij, Bake and Govardhan were known to be pranksters. When the entire village was having such a bad situation, still they had time for the pranks. They would find out new pranks and they would try to scare. It so happened that once these three friends were going beside the village gate, and all of a sudden Govardhan thought, let us play scare everyone. So they started shouting, sing, lion. As you know, they should have definitely led to a reaction from the village. The moment they heard, everyone started to pick up their weapons and started to move from where they had got the sound. But the moment they reached there, they found Bake and Govardhan there. They asked, Brij, where is the lion? Where did you sight them? Seeing the villagers, they started to laugh at them. Their friend had gone successful. They started to laugh and make fun of them. And this, the villagers thought, this was wrong. But after all, it is their own kid. It is a closely knit village after all. The village head, Brij Gopal, said, "Kids, don't repeat this fact." This word had very big, but little did this young kid understand. They were in their own village. Every one of the villagers went back to their house. Few weeks later, as the villagers had an evening in the village, they were peacefully, lazily sleeping in their house. And all of a sudden, they heard a voice. Sing. Lion. And this time, along with sing. They picked up all the weapons and started to move towards the place where they were hearing the voice coming from. They started to rush. Life of someone might be in danger. They started rushing to each other, everyone taking their weapons. But the moment they reached there, it was again those three friends. This time laughing fearlessly at the village. They should have angered any village. But again, we know that they are closely distant. Angered the village. Because I have advised you not to do this. Don't try to defeat it. It is not bad. This world. Hardly they could understand the language. The villagers again dispersed and went back to their homes. And life was again as usual. Everyone busy with their own work, smiled, happiness in the village. Fortunately, for the last few weeks, there had not been any sightings of any lion. It was again a Sunday afternoon. Now these three pranksters were again moving near the same lake. And as they were moving near the same lake, they heard a sound behind the which immediately looked at God. He was known to be the one who was the most mischievous and was the one who knew to do mimicry. They started, "Now don't scare us. We will scare the villager. Don't scare us." The goat was surprised. They moved ahead. A few seconds later, again the same sound. They looked at God again. "Now don't do this to us." They were frightened. Few seconds later, as they moved ahead, they could see a lion like lion in front of them, ready to pounce on them with claws. They were scared. Within seconds, they started to shout, "Sing, sing, sing. Lion, lion, lion." And with the background, this time the villagers heard, but they thought, again they are discouraged by the playing strength, and they let go of this big event that was going to happen to them. They did not react. And why will they? Twice they have been cheated, and twice in front of the game they will be. Without any doubt in their mind, they slept that evening. In the whole night, there were sounds of sing, sing, sing again, but without any response from them. Early morning, and the sun was just starting to rise, village ladies were going to pick up water from the same lake. And the moment when they reached the lake, they found the lake full of, a lake which was drenched in water. And on one side, fierce bodies of those pygmies over the head of the dog. Such was the situation. The whole village went into deep sorrow. But what could they do? There are few lessons in life you should never forget. Credibility takes time to build, and very little time to build. When we talk about credibility, time and again, in our lifetime, we have given so much to live that kind of life. But it takes just a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, it happens same with those big days. Because of their mischief, they have